Hi,
this is Tiger from Robotaxi. Today we are here for the XJ25 extruder and this production arm. And we will get into details about the XJ25 extruder compared with the XJ20 extruder. You can see the SG25 extruder and the production line. We can find the two cooling water tanks and also the stove shelf for the 3D printing filament. Let's get to the extruder. Here is the SJ25 extruder. It can be 120 voltage or 220 voltage. For countries, US or Europe. Compared with SJ20, the SJ25 extruder, the planet could be bigger. I mean, the diameter of the planet could be bigger. So it's more suitable for the recycling plastic. Here is a tank for warm water. And then it comes to the cold water for cooling. And here is another shelf for the filament to return to the stoke shaft, and here is the spools, and here is the metering unit for the whole. Here you can see the whole SJ25 3D filament command. You can find on Robotaxi. This is the desktop or benchtop 3D filament production line solution. And you can see you only need about no more than 3 meters at desktop in your room. So it's not 3 meters, about 2.5 meters desktop. You can have this desktop 3D filament production on. 1 hour about up to 3 kilograms. Here you can see the filament tractor and stocking shelf, metering, and the spooling unit.
the speed can be controlled by the control power.没有收紧吗？
我没有装进去。
啊，没有收紧。The SJ25 shooter can reach about 3 kilograms per hour, but the SJ20, the capacity is about up to 1 kilograms. So the SJ25 production capacity is about 2 twice or third time, three times at the SJ20. Here you can see there is a returning telling unit, and that is the tractor, and there is a stock unit for the filament to control the filament when we want to change the spool. Before the spool, there is a metering unit, and that is a spool for spooling.